Hello everyone, my name is Kushal Singh and I'm an educator on Unacademy. And on this YouTube channel of Unacademy CLAT, we regularly come out with videos that help you with preparation for various law entrance examinations. This channel is not limited to just creating subject videos and theoretical videos. We also have regular videos on GK, editorial reading, practice sessions, paper analysis, and strategy sessions like the one that I am going to take today, wherein we help you with information regarding various law entrance examination. And today I'm here to tell all of you about MHCET, Maharashtra Common Entrance Test, which is an entrance test that students write to get into the 3-year and 5-year programs across various law colleges in Maharashtra. So today's video is going to cover all the details that you might need to know if you are planning on writing the law entrance test of Maharashtra, which is the MHCET. And there are some updates now. A few days ago, the Maharashtra CET dates had been announced and the application was closed. However, the application has been reopened again and we have a few more days. So if you haven't yet applied for Maharashtra CET but are planning on applying, then this video is going to share all the information that you need to apply for MHCET 2021. But before we start the video, let me quickly ask you to subscribe to this channel, to comment on our videos and let us know what kind of videos you would like us to create more. Do you want me to tell you more about any examination? Do you have any doubts about this particular examination? Do let us know in the comments and do not forget to like and share this video, and also do not forget to click on the bell notification so that anytime any of our faculties come live, you will get notified. Without much ado, now let us get into the video. So MHCET, Maharashtra Common Admission Test, or Maharashtra Common Entrance Test. Now, Maharashtra conducts admission to all its law colleges through a centralized CAP model admission. Centralized admission process for which they conduct the Maharashtra CET examination, which happens for various departments, for engineering, for medicine, for pharma, for agri, for law. So this is the Maharashtra CET examination. Now, as far as Maharashtra CET is concerned, there are two kinds of courses that are provided under Maharashtra CET. First one is the 3-year course. Second one is the 5-year integrated course. Three-year course is for the people who have finished their graduation and now want to take up law. And the 5-year integrated course is for students who have just finished their 12th and want to take up the 5-year law course. So that is the major difference. Apart from that, there is some difference in the format of the examination as well. And now let us get into the video where I am going to explain to you and share with you all the latest update of the Maharashtra CET examination. The Maharashtra CET 2021, the final dates haven't been announced yet. But before I tell you about the registration details, let me first tell you about the examination in itself. Like I said before, the examination happens in two categories. One is for the 3-year law and the other is for 5-year integrated law courses. Regardless of which exam you're writing, your examination is going to be online this year due to the COVID protocols. The time for the exam will be 2 hours, and in these 2 hours, you will have 150 questions across syllabus. But the good news here is that unlike the other law entrance examination, there is no negative marking in MHCET, which means that you have complete freedom to even take a guess while you are trying to write the examination. If you don't know the answer for something, you do not leave a question in this paper, rather you attempt it, and if you get it right, or you take a calculated guess, and if you get it right, you get that extra marks. And if it is wrong, you do not have to worry because there is no negative markings and your marks are not going to be reduced just because you got a particular answer wrong, which is a great advantage when it comes to the MHCET examination. Now, like I said earlier, in the last month, the examination and its application for MHCET LLB had opened up and it was closed in the mid of July. However, due to requests from various institutes and students and clashes with the CLAT examination and due to heavy rains all across Maharashtra, a lot of students and institutes requested the universities to once again conduct the examination, to once again, not conduct the examination, pardon me, but to delay or to extend the dates for application, and that has been done now. And as of now, you have time till 9th August. Both the LLB 3-year aspirant and the LLB 5-year aspirant, both of them have time till 9th August. That is a few more days only left, 5 more days left for you to register for the examination. So if you haven't registered for the examination yet, go ahead and do it right away. Where are you going to be able to do all of that? I will let you know in the end of the video that where can you go ahead and submit your application. Now, let us talk about the syllabus and marking scheme for both the LLB 5-year course and the LLB 3-year CET. So the only difference between both of them is that the LLB 5-year CET has 10 marks basic mathematics questions for 10 marks, which is not there in your 3-year CET. So the marks, 10 marks that you would have scored through mathematics is now distributed in the other areas. And what you also see is that the legal aptitude and legal reasoning carries a weightage of 40 marks for the students who write the exam after 12, whereas it carries only 30 marks for students writing after their graduation. The GK and current affairs have similar markings. Pardon me, the GK and current affairs have the difference of 10 markings, that is 10 marks extra for GK and current affairs in the LLB 3-year course. Again, similarly, logical and analytical reasoning, which carries 40 marks in the 5-year course, carries only 30 marks when it comes to the 3-year course. And of course, the English portion, which carries only 30 marks in the 5-year course, has great weightage when it comes to the 3-year examination. So there are some areas which have little bit more marks, which have little bit more weightage, but the advantage is that if you are somebody who is good at English, whose basic English is good, you will be able to get higher marks because there are more number of questions from English when it comes to the LLB 3-year examination. Now, talking about the level of difficulty of this examination. The MHCET examination is a moderate examination, that is, it's not very difficult in terms of the kind of questions it asks. The questions are quite straightforward. Around 60 to 70 questions each year are doable, moderate. It is only 30 to 40% questions which may be difficult. And I can tell you that the English and legal reasoning areas of this examination, whether the 3-year or the 5-year, are fairly easy. It just takes a little bit of practice, and that is all. Not just that, guys, one advantage of writing the MHCET examination, like I told you earlier, is that there is no negative marking. And the format of the examination is like the old CLAT format. That is, it is not a passage-based examination. It is a direct question-based examination where you will be given a direct question and you will be asked to find out an answer from the 4 multiple choices that is given to you. Now, about the application process of the examination, the preparation process of the examination, and the syllabus of the examination. So, like I said, there are 5 subjects in the case of your 5-year examination, and for those who are appearing for the 3-year LLB, you have 4 subjects. For legal aptitude and legal reasoning, your old CLAT format questions or your principle and fact based questions are going to be asked. That is, you will have to learn the basic principles of law from criminal law, law of tort, constitutional law and contract law, and you will be asked questions on the basis, factual questions on the basis of that portion, and you have to arrive at an answer. Fairly easy, fairly doable, and fairly straightforward. The GK and current affairs is a mix of course, your static GK and topics later too. History, geography, general sciences, economics, civics, and also the current affairs of the past 1 year. The advantage here is that there is a huge area that is not current affairs, so you can prepare for it beforehand, and even the current affairs, you can be fairly sure that they are going to ask you questions from the most events that stood out in the year, the current affairs that everybody should know of. They are not going to ask you anything that is out of the ordinary, which again is a great advantage when you're writing an examination. The logical and analytical reasoning questions will include analogies, arguments, drawing conclusions, applying principles and rules, and like I said earlier, are fairly straightforward. How do you prepare for this? The only thing that you need to keep in mind when you're preparing for logical and analytical reasoning is that it takes a lot of practice, it takes a lot of accuracy, which is only developed through practice one after the other. Now, as far as the English portion is concerned, and English portion is very important when it comes to the 3 year law students, because 50 marks of a complete 150 marks ka paper is going to be from the English portion. However, the English portion again is fairly simple and doable. The reading comprehension is not very long, and at the same time, it is not extremely confusing, like in the case of some law entrance examination. Not just that, you don't only have to depend on your reading and comprehending ability, because here they will be asking you questions from various areas like vocabularies, your proficiency in idioms, one word substitution, sentence improvement, para jumble, fill in the blank, common errors. So all these things are going to be asked, and like I said earlier, fairly easy portions in the paper. Now yes, the spotting errors, jumbled paras, there are be one or two questions from each of these areas that you might find slightly difficult, but nothing that cannot be prepared for with some practice. Basic mathematics is on the basis of portions up until 10th, that is profit and loss, speed and distance, time and work, algebra, Venn diagrams, taking the averages, very very basic questions from mathematics. Again, like I said, just some practice and you should be good to go for the examination. Do keep in mind that the basic mathematics portion is not there for the 3 year LLB exam aspirants. And like I said in the beginning of the video, I'm going to share where you can register for the examination. MAHACET, mahacet.org, maharashtracet.org. Now when you visit this website, you will see that it has the listings for many other examinations, for agriculture, for pharmaceutical, for engineering, for medicine. You have to click on the tab which guides you to Maharashtra CET LLB 5 year or 3 year, depending on the course that you are planning to take, and you can register for it. Do not forget, 9th of August is the last date, and also the authority that conducts the examination has very very specifically stated on their website, in their notifications, that no further extensions will be given to anyone under any circumstances. So as of now, 9th of August remains to be the last date for filling your form. Now many of you will be asking, form ka fees kya hai? So if you are planning to write the Maharashtra CET examination, your fees will be 800 rupees for general category, and for the other students, the fees will be 600 rupees, and complete registration process will take a place through this particular website. And once you have written the examination and once you get your score, your colleges will be allotted on the basis of the CAP process. Now if anybody wants to know what are the best colleges under this examination, my personal recommendation would be for two colleges, that try to aim for either of these two colleges. One is your GLC Mumbai and other is your ILS Pune. GLC Mumbai is based in Mumbai and has been the home to some of the greatest legal minds in our country, and not just that, because of its proximity to the Mumbai High Court, a lot of students prefer to go to that college, especially the ones who do crack the examination. The advantage of going to GLC Mumbai is that You will also get access to a lot of lawyers. You will get access to some great internship. As like I said, the Mumbai High Court is Bombay High Court is situated close to the college, and you can, you know, many law offices are also there. So you get an opportunity to go to a lot of these law offices, ask for internship, go to the court and learn things in a very practical sense. Not just that, ILS Pune, again, a very good, a very reputed college for legal studies, a completely dedicated campus just for law, which is something we very rarely see when it comes to colleges, especially colleges that are on a state level. There are colleges that, you know, other colleges in this list would be having multiple other courses, but ILS is one college, apart from GLC, which is very, very specifically dedicated, and the whole campus is dedicated to law. And beautiful campus, great city to be in. So yes, these would be my two topmost recommendations that you should all try to get into these colleges if you can. And like I said, it is not an extremely difficult examination. All it takes is some amount of preparation, some amount of dedication, for which Unacademy is the best platform to help you out. All you have to do is download the application. My code is something that you can use to unlock a lot of free content on Unacademy. You can use my code KUSHALLIVE, Kushal Live. The link to the download description and links will all there be in the description. Click that, open the application, use my code. And if you also want to get a subscription to the Unacademy's complete module of preparation, you can do that as well. All you have to do is click down below, download the application and get the subscription. Not just that, there are a lot of other things which you know, Unacademy offers on its YouTube channel and otherwise, which will help you prepare for the examination. So at Unacademy, we are not just trying to help you with the course material, we also want to be a part of your preparation. So we have a lot of free tests that you can take by downloading the application, where you can check your level of preparedness. You can even use the live quiz feature on the app, where you can self-study and, you know, test your level of knowledge along with your friends. You can host quiz. And the best part that I like of Unacademy, apart from 1/4 the fee from than an institute, apart from extra free months, is that you can learn at your convenience. When I say you can learn at your convenience, at Unacademy, you choose whom you want to learn from, right? You are going to decide who you are going to learn from. You are going to decide when you want to learn. And the reason I say this is that the classes, of course, happen live, but they are also recorded. So if you miss a class now, you don't have to worry. The class will be there. You can later on download the notes. You can watch the video and get your doubts cleared from your faculty in the next session. Not just that, each subject has multiple faculties, which means that you decide from whom you want to learn. So if you have decided to prepare for your MHCET examination, do download the application, start your preparation with Unacademy and all its features on the special platform which provides you free learning. And if you want to prepare for MHCET 2022 or any other law entrance examination, you can also subscribe to Unacademy and get access to all the various question papers, all the detailed batches, all the notes, all the PDFs. So I will see you all there. Best of luck for your examination. Do not forget, 9th August is the last date to register for your MHCET. And if any of you have any further doubts, or if you can suggest me what kind of videos would you like me to make next, do leave a comment down below. I will see you all. Bye-bye and take care.